You excited, buddy?
He was born with leukemia.
What are we going to see?
Rhino.
Had a bone marrow transplant, and then from the complications of all the chemotherapy on his heart, he needed a heart transplant this January. Yeah, we call him Super Cooper.
I'm so excited.
So he was at the Rocky Mountain Hospital for Children just up the street, and so we could actually see kind of City Park from our hospital room, and we used to use that as sort of a end marker goal for when we get out of here, we're gonna take you to the zoo.
Down this ramp?
Yeah.
All right.
I was getting ready to put Rudy outside for the day, and the zoo allows keepers, when they have the time, to do really special things called visitor experiences. And I saw Cooper and his dad.
Is that how he walks?
And I saw that Cooper had been on some oxygen. He had some tubes.
This is like a rhino vitamin. What we gotta do is we gotta put those in these bananas. You wanna help?
Yeah.
Can you stuff one in there?
Push it in there.
Ugh. Good job. Hey, Mr. Rudy.
Look at him.
And so I asked his dad, and his dad was very excited and said Cooper loved rhinos. Buddy. And so we let him pet Rudy right out here. He loves that, Cooper. You're a good massager.
Ever since that day, Cooper's been in love with rhinos nonstop.
Now we can bring him outside because I want to get him out in the sunshine.
Rudy, come out.
When you've been stalked by lions or chased by hyenas or had poachers try to shoot at you, it kind of ruffles your feathers a little bit. So these guys can be pretty tough.
You know, rhinos aren't strangers to adversity, and neither is Cooper, and both of them are facing it head on and so far succeeding.
It's a kind of a interesting connection between the two.
Thank you.
Good job, Cooper.
It's really a priceless gift that he gave us.
90 plus days out of transplant, and we're just, you know, we cherish and we're happy every day that we get to come to the zoo and be away from the hospital.
Bye.